Hello everyone, welcome to lecture on Parity-Check Matrix. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe Parity-Check Matrix and also able to describe and illustrate syndrome testing. Now before starting with the actual session, let's pause the video and think about what is the structure for generator matrix in systematic linear block code. If you remember, generator matrix have form for systematic linear block code as generator matrix equals to combination of parity array and identity matrix. So if you see over here, P is nothing but the parity array and I is nothing but the identity matrix, which is having a size of k by k. So total size of generator matrix is having a much k by n by k by n, means k rows and n columns. Now let's start with the parity check matrix. It is denoted by H and it is used for the decoding the received vectors which is having an error. So for every k by n generator matrix, there is always exist n minus k by n matrix H, which is nothing but the parity check matrix. So basically the rows of generator matrix and rows of H matrix are orthogonal to each other. Orthogonal means what? If you take a dot product of matrix and transpose of that matrix, that gives you the identity matrix. So here G is nothing but the generator matrix and H of T is nothing but the transpose of H matrix, that is transpose of parity check matrix. So dot product of this is gives you the zero. Now to fulfill the orthogonality's requirement of a systematic code, the components of H are written as H equals to I combination of identity matrix and transpose of parity array. If you recall the equation of a generator matrix is having combination of parity array and identity matrix. Here it is similar to that one, only the difference is what? Identity matrix is combined with the transpose of parity matrix, right? So this is nothing but the H, that is parity check matrix. So now the transpose of this parity check matrix is written as rows becomes columns and columns becomes rows. So this identity matrix comes over here and below that we can write transpose of parity check matrix, right? So if you see, this is a identity matrix and this is a parity array. Now it is very easy to verify that the product UHT, here U is nothing but the your code word, set of code word, HT is nothing but the transpose of your parity check matrix of each code word which is generated by G and using of transpose of parity check matrix. So you get the equation is what? UHT equals to P1 plus P1, P2 plus P2, up to how many bits you are having in that array, that is up to n minus k plus n minus k, which is equals to 0. We already seen the equation, that is generated matrix is multiplied with the transpose of parity check matrix, that yields to 0. So where P1, P2 up to Pn minus k are nothing but your parity bits. So thus, once the parity check matrix H is constructed, by using that we can test whether received vector is valid member of the code word set or not. Now it has two conditions for parity check matrix. First, no columns of H can be all zeros. Means if the any column is having zero, so the same effect on the syndrome testing. What is the syndrome testing? We are going to see in the next slides. So at the receiver side, if you going to for the syndrome testing, if you are having all zeros in the column, so that is that does not affect on the syndrome. So you won't be able to detect any error at the receiver side. And second one is all columns of H must be unique. It means if it has same column values at the receiver end, you will getting the same response or same member at the syndrome testing, and you won't be able to distinguish between these two, which one is for which received code word. Now, what is a syndrome testing? It is denoted by R. R is nothing but the received vector at the receiver side, which is generated by the transmitting of the U. U is nothing but your code word. So you transmitted U code word, which is having U1, U2 up to UN, and you are at the receiver side, you are receiving R, which is having R1, R2 up to RN. Now, therefore, at the receiver side, you are, because of the channel, there may be some error gets added in the received code word. So the equation of the R equals to U plus E, where U is your code word and E is nothing but the your error vector, which is having components E1 up to EN. And that error pattern is generated by the channel. As I said, when you transmitted the data at the receiver side through the channel, some error gets added. So the equation for that received code vector is nothing but the U plus E. U is nothing but the transmitted vector and E is nothing but your error vector. So that syndrome is nothing but the S equals to R into H of T, where R is your received vector, H of T is nothing but the transpose of your Parity-Check matrix. Now, it is a result of a Parity-Check matrix performed on the R to determine whether the received R is having a valid member of the code word set or not. So it has two conditions on that. If R is a member, valid member of the code word set, the syndrome S equals to 0. And if it R contains any error which is detected by the syndrome, S equals to non-zero value. So from equation 1 and 2, we can say that S equals to U plus E into H of T, because we know that R equals to nothing but your transmitted code word plus error vector. So you can multiply this in the bracket, you will get U into H of T plus E into H of T. So we already defined for this U into H of T is nothing but equals to 0 in the previous slides. So the equation becomes S equals to E into H of T. So the syndrome test, whether performed on the whether either a corrupted code vector, which is nothing but the E into H of T, or the error pattern that caused it, is the same result. So, or you can say same syndrome. So important property of this, of linear block code, is what? The mapping between correctable error patterns and syndrome is 1-to-1. How? Let's, we can see using one example. Suppose that you are having a code word U, which is nothing but the 101110, is transmitted, and the vector R is received, which is having 00110. That means you are having error in the leftmost bit. You are transmitted 1 and you are received 0 over here. So means this bit is having error. So we have to find the syndrome vector for this using S equals to R into H of T. And also we are going to verify whether we are getting the same syndrome vector by using the equation S equals to E into H of T. So for that, they given the generator matrix G equals to this array, right? So from this, we can see that here N is 6 and K is 3. So you are having 2^3 equals to 8 data word possibles. So these are the 8 possible data words from 000 to 111. Now, we have equation for syndrome, that is S equals to R into H of T. So we have R in the example they given. So this R, and for H of T, we can generate this H of T by using generator matrix. We have H of T equals to nothing but the identity matrix, and below that we can add parity bits, right? So if you perform this multiplication, so row into column, this row into this column, and this row into this column, we'll get 1 for this multiplication, 1 plus 1 for this multiplication, and again 1 plus 1 for this multiplication. Final result we are getting is what? 1, 0, 0. So this syndrome we are getting from the equation S equals to R into H of T. Now this we are going to verify using equation S equals to E into H of T. So E is what? Received error bit, the vector, that is 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and H of T is what? This one. So if you multiply this, again you are getting the same result. So this is how we are going to verify the syndrome at the receiver side. These are the references. Thank you.